Hi, I'm Daphne Richards. Our question this week comes from Kim Johnson about her Texas persimmons. Kim says that last fall, blisters appeared on the leaves of her young persimmon tree. She's tried spraying with water and insecticidal soap, but the blisters remain, and now some of the new growth has them. What is it, and what can she do about it? Well, Kim, these are persimmon leaf galls, which are caused by a mite, which lays its eggs on the leaves, causing the plant to react by producing those blister-like cysts on the surface. Since the leaf tissue surrounds and protects the young mites, spraying with any sort of product won't have any effect, so there's no need to waste your time or money. While the mites definitely aren't the best thing for the plant's healthy growth and development, they usually aren't more than a nuisance and the plant recovers. Because your tree is so young, with so few leaves, it's a bit more of a problem simply because the plant doesn't have as many leaves to compensate for the issue. But ultimately, as the tree gets larger, the problem will be less of an issue. Most times, mites and other gall-making insects are cyclical problems, often with many years of non-infection between problem years. Texas persimmons are tough, and my bet is that your tree will overcome this setback. Treat the plant the way you would if it were completely healthy, and the problem should right itself within a few seasons, and hopefully sooner. Our plant this week is Euphorbia rigida, commonly known as silver spurge or gopher plant. This mounding perennial is often referred to as a shrub, but it definitely does not fit most people's mental image of what a shrubby plant is, since it doesn't get woody or even all that large. In years with warmer winters, silver spurge may be evergreen, but the stems do die back after flowering, so it's best if you prune out those old, dead stalks at the end of the flowering season. Getting to about 2 feet tall and spreading to about 3 feet wide, silver spurge looks great along the borders of garden beds, perhaps with a bit of space to flop over and trail slightly over the edge. Bright yellow flower clusters form in late winter and early spring, and silver spurge will flower well into the summer. Leaves are a bright gray, making the plant really stand out. Plant in full sun or only light shade, in well-drained, even rocky soils, and water about once a month unless we're getting rain. Our viewer picture this week comes from Phyllis and Charlie Hurst. This is a bottle tree made from hand-blown tequila bottles, and it's really cute. We'd love to hear from you, so please head on over to klru.org/ctg to send us questions and photos from your garden.